We're going to get right down to business with episode one of a for-profit show. What? I'm going to start out with a little bit about MSI and the faith that I carry. Now, I don't really care. I really don't care what your faith is. As long as you recognize that faith is, and faith is the most important. Now, I'm not saying that knowledge is not important. I'm not saying that other things aren't important. But faith, come on. Let's be real. Let's get down to business, okay? Faith is the most important thing. Why? That is why. That's why. Because this whole thing, the whole thing that we're doing, what is this we're doing? Like, what is actually happening? What's going on? I mean, the reality of our existence. No. I know you're thinking, no, it's this, no, it's that. Nobody knows what the heck is going on. Really? No, honestly. Honestly. Now, I believe very much so in the Most High God. And the Most High God sent my Lord, Jesus Christ. Now, I don't care about you, little ego, and what it believes, okay? And you shouldn't care about what my little ego, does, and thinks, and feels, and believes in. But we gotta come together on faith, at capital F, for the one true love, the one true God that is, that was, that will always be. And if that isn't Jesus for you, that's okay. That's okay. I just want to get up front. I want to get right up front with what I is, what I am, and what I wants. Okay? No, seriously, let's get down to business here. Let's really talk about God. Let's really talk about film. And let's really talk about funny. Film, faith, and funny. Let's really talk about these things. I mean, like, come on. Come on. Let's really get out of here. Yeah. Because all I want to do is talk about these things. All I want to do is talk with other people about these things. And we're going to start with my faith. We're going to start with what I feel to be God, what I know to be God, what I believe to be God, and why it is I believe what I believe. I'm not trying to convince anybody of anything. I am not evangelical. I am very much so not evangelical. So much so that evangelicals are going to be like, what is he talking about? Okay? I'm not trying to convince you of Jesus, and I'm going to get into Buddha. I'm not going to try to convince you of Buddha. I'm not going to try to convince you to watch movies. I'm not going to try to convince you that comedy is amazing, but let's be honest. I mean, come on. Get out. Let's get down to business here. We need to be laughing. We need to be crying. We need to be rejoicing. We need to be knowing. We need to be feeling. And we need to do this right now. Why? Because there's only now. There's only now. There only was now. There only will always be now. Now. Let's get down to business. MSI, Mark Stewart Iverson. I was born in 86 to great, wonderful parents. As screwed up as they made me, like everybody else, I am so blessed. I am blessed beyond understanding. Truly, it's hard to put into words how blessed I really am. And that's the thing. That's why I have to have faith. That's why I believe so much in God, because I'm so blessed. And others are not so blessed. I'm blessed with amazing family. I am blessed with an amazing skill set that God gave me. Skills that I've worked on, absolutely. Skills that I'm still very much so working on, including faith, but blessed beyond compare. And so, I mean, the fact that I'm even sitting here starting a show, a podcast, talking to people about this stuff, I have extra time. I don't have to be working three jobs. I'm actually just working two right now, but so... How did I come to God? Well, let's first start with how I went away with God. Ooh, did I say no to God? Oh, did I say no to God? I was like, God, and no. And he was like, what? Seriously, I said big time no to God. 16 years old, I decided, no, I don't believe in God. Not the God that was presented to me. Not the God that was presented to me. Not the concept. Not the concept of God that was presented to me. I was a movie guy. Films, baby. It's all about the storytelling and the medium of the film. Still love the film. Making films. I'm a filmmaker. I'm an artist. God truly wants me to do this. Yet, It was that I had faith in growing up. I had faith in the storytelling. I had faith in cinema. I had faith in movies, but I had faith in artistry, you know, the art of this specific medium that I was so into, so all about. From Superman, oh, before I could even talk, I saw that movie, and man, that was the impression. And then grew into filmmakers, you know, Paul Thomas Anderson. You know, nowadays I'm really, really into the new people, the people coming up, Greta and Jordan. Oh man, these guys, everybody coming up, Damien. Oh yeah, just you know, fantastic filmmakers. And I believed in cinema. That's what I had faith in. I had faith in that and that alone. I didn't need God. Certainly not the God that was presented to me. Again, the concept of God that was presented to me. Because like you, most of you out there, no matter what you are, maybe you're mostly Christian. That's great. I'm Christian. Okay, I've come to terms with that. But the God that was presented to me and the God that is presented to most people is a concept. It doesn't matter what religion you're in, what country you're in, what nationality. It is a concept you are presented with, a concept of God, not the reality. Not the reality of God, but the concept of God. That is what you are presented with. You must believe this about God, the concept. Well, I couldn't accept the concept of God because concepts are in your head. I couldn't have put those words like that together. I couldn't have thought of it like that when I was 16, when I was saying, nah, 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 I'm good, God, I don't need you. I don't need you, God, I'm good. I'm good with, nah, you're good, you're good, I'm good with this, we'll just be good. I said it just like that too. I said no to God because I didn't need God the concept, because I didn't understand God the concept until I started to actually understand realities and concepts and the differences between them. I actually had a class, a philosophy class, that helped me believe in God. Why? Because in that philosophy class, I was taught for the first time something I intuitively knew, but I couldn't put into words. And what was that? The difference between concepts and objects. Wait, what? What's the difference between concepts and objects? I don't understand. What's the difference between concepts and objects? Let me break it down for you. The object is the reality of the thing. The microphone, the camera, the body, the brain, the actuality, the earth, the moon. And then there are concepts. Your concept, my concept, anybody's concept of those things. Those things, though, are separate from the way we think about them. So I have a concept of my mother. That is not the object, my mother. My mother is my mother. My mother is an object. My concept of my mother is a separate thing altogether. They are correlated, but they are not the same thing. So let's go back to God. Well, God, the concept didn't make sense to me. It really didn't. Allah, Jesus was great. I mean, he's super cool, right? Anybody who knows anything about anything has to accept the fact that Jesus was baller. Just straight up baller. Rock star, punk rock, hardcore, are you kidding me? Baller. Straight savage. Let's get to the millennial talk. Straight savage. He crushed it. He was crushing it. He was destroying it. Dominating. Anybody has to accept that. Whether or not you accept him into your heart of hearts as your Lord and Savior, that's up to you. I'm not evangelical. It helped me, and I'm going to talk about it. But I'm also going to get into just simply the reality of God for everybody, okay? And the reality is not the concept. The reality is not the concept. I'm cool. I was always cool with Jesus the dude. What a sweet dude. Buddha, holy shoot. What a freaking amazing dude. Whoa, stop you in your tracks, like, whoa, holy crap, Ola. Like, what are you talking about? Are you serious right now? But the concept of God? First of all, intuitively, I must have known that the concept of God was different for every single person because everybody has different concepts of everything. Going back to the example, my mother is an object. My concept of my mother is my concept of my mother. My concept is separate from my sister's concept of my mother. But my mother, the object, is still there. So how did I come back to God? Slowly but surely, not just that philosophy class learning about concepts and objects. Slowly but surely, many things got me back to God. What I actually like to say is that God got me back to God, of course. And I'm so cool with using the word God now. I used to not be cool with using the word God because God was a concept to me. He wasn't reality. Even if you don't like me saying he. Okay, I like to say he. If you want to think she, if you want to think it, that's actually kind of weird. It, no, it's the movie with the red balloon. No. Okay. God is get. And get, God is get. And, you know, I really don't care, again, if I've offended you. It doesn't really matter to me. I don't care, because the thing that's offended is the concept of you in your head, your ego. What? Oh, back to concepts and objects. There we are. So I don't care if my pronouns fuck you up. Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm a man of God, and I just said, fuck, what? Cover your ears, children, this is rated R. Again, concepts and objects. The reality of God came to me, slowly but surely, in all different kinds of ways. And the biggest, maybe most important thing that happened was me learning and understanding Buddha. Truly. Truly. Because once I learned and understood Buddha, then I understood my body, my mind, and my connection there. And guess what happened? I went back to Jesus and was like, yo, dude, I get it, B. And he was like, that's what I'm saying. Actually, I should probably do it. That's what I'm saying. I don't know if that's Jesus' voice. More like, that's what I was saying, young man. Even that, I mean, again, concepts of Jesus. You know what I mean? The reality of Jesus is your personal relationship. But you don't need to have a personal relationship with Buddha. See, that's the thing. I can't stop talking about Buddha and Jesus because it's number one, number two, right there. Just simple. Number one, number two. Just simple. Number one, Jesus. Number two, Buddha. Simple. East, west. West, east. Left, right. Up, down. In, out. If we just get it right down to business, if we go to the minutiae, to the little things, what we find is that there's positive and there's negative in this life. Now, I'm not saying that the yin-yang of this life is the only life. That's where I have faith. That is where I have faith in the one true God, the Most High God, who sent Jesus for a purpose to represent Him. And who also, same God, yes, same God, sent the Buddha. Why? To teach us about meditation. Sit on your butt, observe your sensations, observe your breath, and there you go. There you go. That's it. That was his teaching. That's what he taught. He did not teach, follow me. I am the way, I am the truth, and I am light. That's Jesus. You want to know what Buddha did say? One of the last things he said? You want to know? Wait, you want to know? He said, don't listen to anything I've said. No, literally. He said, don't listen to anything I've said. Wait, literally, he said, don't listen to, like, anything I've said. Instead, meditate, sit on your butt, observe your sensations, observe your breath. That's what you do. Don't worship Buddha as God. Most people even think that the meditation I'm talking about is Zen. Zen was developed 500 years after the Buddha's death. Da Buddha died 500 years later. Some dudes were like, nah, Vipassana is too hard. Let's do Zen. Oh, yeah, Vipassana. Vipassana. Ever heard of Vipassana? Vipassana. It's a meditation I do. You want to know what it is? It's the original meditation that the Buddha taught. Oh, and it's super difficult. It's very, very, very hard to keep up, especially outside of the retreats. You go on a 10-day retreat, silent, no phones either, nothing. You can't even look people in the eye, really. You get some good vegetarian food, and you sit on your butt for 10 hours a day, and you observe your breath, and you observe your sensations. Simple, done. That's it. You could take 60 years and completely become enlightened. Or you could try to just bring it into your regular life and not try to achieve enlightenment, which I don't actually think is the purpose of most people's lives. Very, 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 very few people have ever even gotten close to achieving enlightenment, let alone achieved it. I'm talking about true enlightenment. I'm not talking about being enlightened, having enlightened thoughts, understanding your body, your mind, and your soul very well. Yes, you're enlightened. Sure, whatever you want to say. You have not achieved enlightenment. Not the actual enlightenment. Not really. But you can with Vipassana. You just take 60 years, that's all. You got 60 years, nothing to do. Sit in your butt and observe your sensations in your breath. Done. And that's the thing, working with sensation. Once I worked with sensation, as the Buddha originally taught in this style of Vipassana, once I worked with sensations, I was like, oh my Lord, I have a body, I have a mind, oh Lord, what is going on? I mean, really. What is going on? I mean, really. You don't know until you understand your body and your mind. Going back to what I said, nobody knows what's really going on. This experience is nutsoid, okay? The human experience is cray. Again, millennial talk. Cray. Like super cray. Like cray cray. Actually, it's cray cray. Let's be real. Let's get down to business. It is cray cray. This, seriously, this life is nuts. And that's why you need faith. Now, you can have faith in the Buddha. That's great. But what you should have faith in with the Buddha is the teaching of the Buddha. And the teaching of the Buddha is meditation, Vipassana style. Sit on your butt, observe your sensations and your breath, your natural breath, your bare breath, the breath that breathes with the life that is, not the breath that you decide to breathe with your brain, but the true breath, the actual breath, the deepest, deepest breath, Big B breath, breath of life, the one that God gave you, the soul connected to the breath is what God gave you. You do not need your ego to breathe. You need only God. And so go to your natural breath, observe your sensations. That's what the Buddha taught. Faith in that. Have faith in that. I'm not saying Buddhists out there, you're wrong either. I'm not. Please don't be offended. Actually, I don't care, remember, because it's your ego who would care. But what I am saying is that if you boil it down, if you get real simple with it, you need to have faith. You need to have faith. I have faith. I have such faith. And yes, I have doubts. Oh, Lord, do I have doubts. Oh, Lord, do I have doubts. Oh, Lord, do I have doubts. I have doubts. I have so many doubts. But it's faith that gets me up in the morning. It's faith that gets me through the day. It is faith in the one trueness. It is faith in that which is, was, will always be. It is faith that the is that is, like really is. And that it matters that it is. Because that's my God, okay? That's my God. And yes, in this life, there is the self and there is no thing. And that's what it gets down to, the self and no thing. That's the binary system. That's the Jesus Buddha, okay? And ironically, it's Jesus who represents no thing and Buddha who represents self. It is simply that no thing came down and had some self in Jesus, because it is no thing that is most closely related to the one true God, the Most High God, because God is no thing. God is no thing. God is God. God creates things. God made things. The things that are because of God. Right? Right? I mean, come on. Things are just things. The self is a thing, is it not? The self cannot be God. The self is not God. The universe is not God. Now, I understand that I might just offend some people right there because, well, I believe the universe is God. I believe the universe is God. You can have faith in the universe, absolutely. But the universe is a creation of God because the universe will cease to be at some point. Because, I don't know if you know this, but the universe is a thing. And things do not last forever. The only thing that lasts forever is no thing. Nothing lasts forever, literally. No thing lasts forever, literally. Literally, no thing lasts forever. Therefore, it is before things, it will be after things. It is not a thing, it is no thing. And God is there. The self is represented by Buddha. Why? Because he destroyed the evil self and rose that deep self, that true self, that soul self, the self that is connected to the universe, the self that knows it is the universe. You are the universe. You, the true you, are the universe. That is why you are also not God, because if you actually believe that you are God, then you get into some craziness. Like super cray. But Buddha represents the self and God represents no thing, and that's the duality. That's the binary system going on right here. If we boil it down, if we get down to benya, about God and the reality of this life, is that yes, it is binary. It is. Yes, there's a oneness, absolutely. But regardless of the truth of the oneness, you are an ego and a soul. You are binary. In your experience, in your body, you are binary. You are duality. Okay, this is why I personally have accepted Jesus Christ into my heart of hearts. He is my Lord of lords. He is the King of kings to me. I have faith in him. Why? Because this life is broken and screwed up. And we're messed up. And we're sinners. We are mad sinners. Oh, you don't like the word? You're offended by the word sinner? Well, you know what? Then you're just egoic. And if you don't think you're egoic, you're super egoic. You got a giant ego if you don't think you have an ego. That's the truth. That is the truth of this life. And that is what I have come to know as God. And I can't stop talking about God. I didn't even really get into movies very much in this first epi right here because I just love talking about God. In my work, all I want to do is talk about spirituality, faith. I don't want to really even get into religion that much because then I offend people. So I just want to talk about God because a lot of people love God. And everyone's got interpretations, but God's God. And if you love God, if you believe in God, if you have faith in God, then we're on the same page. Okay? If you don't like the word God, we still can be on the same page. And we got to get on the same page here, right? And God is just, man, he is ever, ever present. Truly. He is presence itself, capital P. I mean, right here and now is the only thing that is presence. You need to connect with presence. How do you get to God? Presence. Present moment. Nowness. Right now, you pray. Right now, you meditate. Right now, you think, oh God, help me. Oh God, believe. And I really do feel, truly, madly, and deeply, that all of the things I will be talking about, all of the things that I want to be talking about, all the things I want to be doing are all connected. Film, faith, and funny. Film, faith, and funny. So connected. Your laugh. That's funny, right? That's funny, right? That's funny, right? Right? Funny. Film, faith, and funny. Film. Art, expression, truth through a medium, expressing yourself honestly, whatever it is, that's that your career. We're creators. We're made by a creator, the creator, the most high creator. And we are creators, so we create. We have to tell our truth to the truth because there is only one truth and everybody's got a different one. That's kind of a Zen koan. But it's real. And my truth, my expression, my honest expression is film. Has been. It continues to be. It could be other things. I want to write novels. I want to do television, of course. I want to do all kinds of things. But I need to express myself honestly through the medium of film. And I'm going to be talking about God. I'm going to be talking about faith. I'm going to be talking about all of it in a funny way. I'm making comedies. At least this first big project I'm going to be doing. This first big movie I'm putting all of it on. I'm banking it all on. I'm begging, borrowing, and stealing every dime I can get from myself and my family friends in order to make a movie, make a feature film. Why? Because this dude God is like pushing me over the edge to do it. This crazy dude God. Yeah, but you know, all I want to do is connect to connection and speak truth to truth and power to power and oneness to oneness. I want to hear with my ears. You know, I really want to hear with my ears. That's the thing. Oh, man, that's the thing. And that's the one thing that Jesus repeats over and over again in the Bible, in the gospel, that connects so well to what the Buddha was saying. So well, it's unbelievable that I haven't even read the connection before. I actually made this connection because God showed me this connection. And the connection is, you have to hear with your ears. What does that mean?
Well, it means listen, like really listen, like hard.
What it means is physically listen with your physical, actual object of your ear, the objects of your ears. Listen with your ear, hear with your ear, your actual physical ear. And how do I know this? Because I meditated like the Buddha. And I understood the sensations. Whoa, whoa, yes. The body, the brain, the connection there. Whoa. Hear with your physical ear. Hear with your physical ear. Not interpretation with your egoic mind. So Jesus says, you who have ears to hear must hear. He repeats this over in so many different ways. And every version, because there's so many versions of translations of the Bible. In every one, it is always ear. It is always the physical ear. He's always talking about the physical ear. He's not talking about the metaphor of listening. He's talking about the actuality of hearing with your ears. And you must do that. It is so hard not to get caught up in the interpretation of your mind, because sight, feeling, taste, touch, hearing, whatever it is going to be taken by the ego and then said, no, this is what you should think. The ego is going to interpret. That is its job. That is why it's so hard. Why we are in a binary system. It's because our ego decides, no, I'm going to decide what you think. No, I got this soul. Don't worry about it. No, you go back to sleep. No. You can't do it. You can't let it happen. You can't let your ego take over. You have to do everything possible to separate that and understand that you need to be hearing with your ears, seeing with your eyes, feeling with your heart and your body, tasting with your tongue, smelling the salts and waking up. That's what you need to be doing. You need to be doing that. Not checking how many likes you got on Instagram. Really. No, I love checking how many likes I got on Instagram. I'm not above you, okay? I have a giant ego, and I'm working very hard every day to reduce it, and it is not happening easily, okay? I'm meditating like the Buddha, and I have unbelievable faith in Jesus Christ. I put it together, and that's my faith. That's it, right there. Boom. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Step in line with God now. Here and now. I express myself honestly through film. I'm going to be putting every dime I have into making this film. That's why I'm making a documentary about making this film, because I need to have a safety net, because if the film goes bust, then I have a great documentary about how I failed. That's funny. I make it, it's a comedy. It really is. It's a comedy. It's a comedy about faith. Is it going to work for the faith-based market? Hopefully, I think so. I don't know. I really am trying very, very desperately trying to make it the greatest movie it can be. My voice, truly. I want to only do the will of He who sent me, truly. And we'll see. We'll see what happens. But moving forward, we're going to have a great time with this podcast, with this show. Come on. A for-profit show. Let's do it, baby. Let's do it, baby. Come on, babies. Come on, honeys. Let's do it. And I'm not just talking to women. That was sexist. If I was just talking to women, I'm talking about men, women, anywhere in between. I'm with you. As long as the you is you and not you. And it's hard. It's hard in this binary system. But we got to have faith. For me, it's faith in film and funny. And that's what we're going to be talking about. In every other episode, I think I'm going to bring on some friends, some colleagues, some people who want to talk about film, faith, and funny. Otherwise, I'm going to be rambling on about God, about spirit, about movies, about comedy. And we're going to be doing it upright. We'll be doing it good. We're going to be doing it all the time. Thanks for listening. Thanks for tuning in. And let's end with a little bit of a prayer. A little bit of prayer. All I got to say is,